Hello everyone and welcome back to Genie Crafts. So today's video is yet another portrait paper cutting video where we are going to focus on how to bring about detail in the hair, especially if it's a female portrait. So this is the photograph that was given to me as part of a commission, and now we are going to see how to create a stencil that can encapsulate as much detail in the hair as possible. So open the free picture stencil maker website and upload the photograph there to start. There are two modes which are perfect for getting minute details on your portrait. First is the edges mode, which you will see on the left hand side, and it is the default mode in which the website renders. And then the second mode is the adaptive mode, which is a slightly easier mode. So if you are not too much experienced with portrait paper cutting, I would advise not to go with edges mode because it really brings about quite a lot of details, and it is not good if it is just not face but rest of the body is also part of the portrait. But if it's only face, then edges mode is a good mode. So as you will decrease the darkness and the sharpness, you will keep on increasing the details on your portrait. But for this portrait, we are going to go with the adaptive mode. To bring about the details, all you need to do is to keep increasing the darkness and the sharpness and stop at a point with which you feel comfortable enough that you'll be able to do justice to the details that are appearing on the stencil. If you feel it is too much, you can always reduce the sharpness and, you know, reduce the number of details on the portrait. But if you have got a picture in which, you know, the hair is flowing with the wind and, you know, it's quite close up, then it's always best to bring about as much detail in the hair as possible, because for the rest of the portrait, there will not be much details. On the face, there are only eyes, nose and lips, and then on the dress, most of the times I have seen that artists just ignore the any design on the dress. If you are able to bring the design, well and good, but if you are not, then the only thing that is left to make your portrait detailed enough is the hair. So try to bring as much detail in the hair as possible, and when you are happy with the details, click on the download and print out your template. And here is the template that I prepared previously for the commissioned work that I did, and as you can see that there is lot of details in the hair. The paper that I have used for this portrait is a textured off-white color 220 GSM thickness paper. Nowadays I'm using this brand Paper Pep, which I am in love with because they have got so many colors in their collection. So I utilize these papers for creating portraits, whether they are colored portraits or whether they are black and white portraits. So like I said before, we'll start with the hair because that is going to consume the chunk of my time, and mostly I've decided to cut out all the black portions in the hair and preserve the white areas to bring about the details in the hair. Also around the border, I will not cut out the black areas, but I will preserve the black areas to bring about those details of flowing hair. But first let's do the inside portions, where without thought I can just simply remove the black portion. Now I have done a lot of portrait videos on how to cut the hair and what areas to cut and what areas not to cut, so I'm not going to go into the details of those. You can refer to my older videos on portrait paper cutting. I have put the links on the top of the screen so you can click them. But other than that, take care of few things that ensure that all the white areas that you are not cutting are interconnected to each other, so that accidentally you do not remove a chunk from your template. Also make sure that your blade is sharp. Choose a blade with which you have better control. Do not try to smoothen out the details from the template because you have purposely printed a highly detailed template, so try to bring out as much detail as possible and try to bring out those tiny edges, curves and, you know, lines jutting out from the template. So try to do all those things and your final result is going to be awesome. So here we are after doing majority of the hair. I will just flip the paper to show you how much detail I have captured. As you can see that now the hair is really looking detailed. Accidentally I removed few chunks of, you know, white areas, but it was surrounded by uncut areas, so it didn't, you know, appear too bad. So I let it be, otherwise I would have joined those pieces back again. Now it's time for bringing out the design on the dress. Now as you can see that there are a lot of small dots on the dress, and that is mostly because my sharpness was very high when I created the stencil, and I need not be bothered about bringing out those details. So now it's up to me to decide how to cut the dress what all designs I want to bring. So all those designs that are clearly outlined on the dress, I'm definitely going to cut them and bring them out. But other than that, I'm going to leave those small dots as it is. I'm not going to spend time on that. But what I'm definitely going to do is that I'm going to make sure that all the black areas which are representing the folds in the dress or creases on the sleeve of the dress or on the rest of the dress, I'm definitely going to cut those areas to bring about those details, because it should not look like a flat surface when you look at the portrait. It should actually feel like that the person is wearing a dress, the person is wearing something which has creases, which has fold, so it looks more natural. So that's what I'm going to do. But other than that, other small details, I'm going to let it be. And now it's time to work on the face area. Just remember everything that I have told in my previous videos, the things that you need to take care of, and do not hurry, especially not on the face, because one mistake and you're done. You'll have to redo your portraits. Reattaching parts on the face area normally does not work, especially on the eyes. So you'll have to be careful while you're doing the face. So take your time, do it slowly, do it carefully. It was a commissioned portrait. I spent a lot of time on doing the face, and especially that earring, which is looking really complex. I was not able to bring about all the design on the earring because the dots were so close to each other, but I brought about sufficient design to look like that it was a earring. Now that we are done with the rest of the portrait, now it's time to remove that empty negative space around the portrait so that when you frame it, it looks good. So what you need to do is that you need to cut around the border. The hair portion is tricky in this portrait because the hair is flowing in the wind. So all the strands of hair that you see as black lines, you have to cut on both sides of those black lines so that you can cut out those hair rather than removing it, you preserve it. And any chunk of, uncut area that you see near those, you can always do your own design to make sure that it doesn't look very chunky or very uncut at the end. So do that and take your time to cut this portion of the border because it is tricky, and you will need to apply your own judgment what you need to keep and what you need to remove. Once you're done with the border cutting, carefully remove the empty negative space around your portrait. If you're not able to remove it as a single piece, you can always break it into different pieces and then remove it. Just ensure that you're not damaging the portrait, so do not pull if there is any undercutting. Carefully remove it. And this is how the portrait has turned out to be. It has come out really nice and much better than I expected. The details are really good in this portrait. I hope you all enjoyed this video on portrait paper cutting, on how to bring about more details in your portrait. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to reach out to me on my Insta ID or on my YouTube. Just drop me a comment and I'll answer. Also, if you guys like the video, then please do not forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends. Also, to subscribe to my channel for regular videos on paper arts, and I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Till then, stay safe, take care, and bye bye.